Go to the Tools panel of Affinity Photo and go for Callout Ellipse Tool. Personally, I think of it as a word balloon or speech balloon, and select that. And what you do, simply draw it. Just, it's a vector size, so it can be any size you want, maybe small, and you can change it. Obviously, you can stretch it, go that way, go that way. You can also rotate it like that if you want to do that. Generally, it's always probably up that way. We've also got other settings here. You can set it with a fill. You can also set it with gradient. So if you want to, you can just quickly add a gradient. Personally, I wouldn't do that. I prefer just to keep it blank, which is, of course, just go over here to the swatch there or there, and you've got no fill at all. You can vary the stroke color. And again, you can go for the color there. You can go for red, but generally it's always black in comic books, but it could be any color, I guess. No reason why it should be just black. And also you can go here and you can set styles. Now, you should be able to set the dash. It hasn't been working for me. I'm not certain why this one does not work. However, you can also alter other things. So I'm just going to go to this option here, which personally I think is easier, which is there, and the width. So you can see you can change the width. You've also got pressure, and that makes it a lot more flexible. You don't have to use that. You can always reset it just to your standard sort of design there, where it's all solid all the way around. And also you can vary this as well. So you can see it just changes that. Not vast amount of functionality there, but it still does mean you get slightly different design. You make in, out, etc. But I prefer this pressure, which is really quite nice. So you can just make a more dramatic word balloon than what you normally get. Of course, you can put some text in it if you want. Now, just wow, something like that. So you can quickly add that, of course, and change the font as required. But you can also, of course, duplicate it. You don't have to hold down the Alt or Option key and duplicate it. You can see you can create a sort of unusual effect that way. You can, of course, go over here and you can apply styles, obviously, because it's just like that. Probably not going to be much use for, I think. But again, if you want a nice green garish color for your balloon, it could be of some use. Also, if you want maybe a slightly more effects to this, probably be best to do it in Affinity Designer, because you can add appearances to this. Also, interactively, to change this, just go over here to the actual tool there again, go back down to the Callout Ellipse tool, and you've got some tools here, and you can just modify these little red dots just down there. You've got exactly the same settings here as well, so you can use those if you want. And you can change that, push that up there. Personally, I like to keep it more rounded, but each their own. And you can squeeze that in. I think it's nice to have a little bit of a gap. And you see, you can just move that back and forth. Unfortunately, you can't stretch it out right over the other thing. And also, you can't flip it inwards or flip it over and all those sort of things. It'd be nice if you could do, but however, it can just go from there to there, 0 to 100%. And you can do all that from the slider up here. Well, what you can also do, of course, is I'm just going to remove the wow now because I don't want that. Of course, you can also fill it with something else. So you just go up here, top right, and maybe select that, and then go over here to the various tools, maybe the rectangle tool, and you can fill it with design like that. Of course, in this case, maybe fill it with something like that. So you can create more interesting word balloons that way. And of course, you can still move that around, duplicate that design, and so on. Great. I'd say slightly more interesting designs than normal. Also, you can apply effects. However, if you apply effects, what happens? It becomes a pixel layer, which you may not want. But if you don't want that, what you can do, you can go to Layer, with that selected, of course, go to Layer and New Live Filter Layer, and maybe Blur or Gaussian or Distort, maybe go for Ripple or Displace. So Ripple, and you can see what happens. You get a nice ripple effect for your word balloon. Now, unfortunately, this gets rippled as well, but you can manipulate that by changing the position, maybe put the center there so it's not so bad, maybe masking, etc. You could manipulate that further. But you can see and create far more interesting designs that way. Also, you can go over here, and I'm just gonna have to find it now. Oh, there it is, the layers panel. So you've got the layers, it's just a standard layer. You can always add colors. So you can always go to layer and your adjustment layer, maybe color it in different ways, depending on obviously what's in the fill and the actual stroke. But you can also go down the bottom and you've got a little FX. So if you want to, maybe go there, outer shadow. So just go there and you've got a nice outer shadow effect appearing there. Gives it a bit of depth for your word balloon as well, if you want that. Or maybe go for outline so you can create a nice outline for that. So maybe have a, so go for like red around it, sort of an angry but word balloon. And of course, as with all things, you can duplicate it multiple times, move it around, resize it, rotate it, etc. So you could have more than that, obviously, and then just duplicate that design and have obviously across maybe some cartoons, comic strips, etc. If you have a design that you like of your callout ellipse, what you can do, just go up here, just select that little gear there, little settings, and what you can do, go to the right side there and click create preset. Straight away, you can create a preset. So callout ellipse 3. And of course, you can give it a category, etc. If you want, I'm just going to click create, and you can see straight away now you've got another ellipse there, or word balloon, which you of course can now bring back at any point. So if you got that selected, just go up here and you can click there and just apply it again, select that one, and you can see the variations there. You can also convert it to curves. So convert to curves, just click there, or right click and go down to convert to curves. Once you've done that, you can go over to the node tool and you can modify your design. So if you decide, you know what, I don't want exactly a standard sort of call out ellipse or word balloon, you can just modify it in a number of different ways to create some more unique designs. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.